In this video, we're going to draw Lewis structures in 3-dimensional following the VSEPR theory. We will focus on drawing structures with steric number 2, 3, and 4 in this video. Structure with steric number 2 will have two groups connected to the central atom. In this example, the central atom is in pink and surrounded by two groups at 180 degrees. Structure with steric number 3 will have three groups connected to the central atom. The three groups are at the same plane and they are spaced at 120 degrees. Structures with steric number 4 will have four groups connected to the central atom. The central atom is surrounded by four groups at 109.5 degrees. To understand what steric number is it's basically atom that is connected to the central atom through single, double, or triple bond. If there's a lone pair on the central atom, that's counted as steric number 1 as well. We'll see a few examples for steric number and it'll make more sense. Starting with steric number 2. That means our central atom is connected to two groups. We have HCN as our example. Carbon is our central atom and it's connected to two groups. Single bond to H, triple bond to N. That's steric number 2. That means the two groups will want to arrange itself as far apart from each other, and that's at 180 degrees in a linear shape. Therefore, the 3D structure will look exactly like the 2D Lewis structure. We start with carbon in the middle, and then we have a single bond to hydrogen, and then a triple bond to nitrogen. For linear shape, all the atoms are on the same plane. Moving on to steric number 3. Our central atom is now connected to three groups. We have BCl3 as our example. B is our central atom and it's connected to 3Cl through single bond. That's steric number 3. The three groups will want to arrange itself as far apart from each other at equal distance, and that results in 120 degrees bond angle, and that's a triangular shape. We start with boron in the center, and then we connect boron to each of the chlorine through single bond. For triangular shape, all the atoms are at the same plane. The bond angle is 120 degrees. Staying on with steric number 3, let's look at another example, which is SO2. In this Lewis structure, you can see that it has three steric numbers due to the three groups. One single bond, one double bond, and one lone pair. However, because we have a lone pair on the central atom, the shape for this molecule is no longer triangular. Instead, it's bent, or sometimes called as angular. To draw SO2 in 3D, we start with S in the center, and then we draw out the three lines at 120 degrees from each other. We place the two oxygens like this with a double bond, and then we remove the extra bond, and then we add in the lone pair. With that, we've drawn SO2 in 3D. Since SO2 has steric number 3, all the atoms are in the same plane. Moving on to steric number 4, we have CF4 as an example. Since we have four groups surrounding the central atom, each of them will want to be as far apart from one another at an equal distance, and that turns out to be 109.5 degrees. This kind of arrangement is called tetrahedral. To draw CF4 in 3D, we start with carbon in the center. We then draw out four bonds. The first one will place a solid line to show that it's on the same plane of the screen, and another solid line which is also on the same plane on the screen. Now for the remaining two bonds, notice in the model here, one of the bond is pointing to the front of the screen, and the other bond is pointing backwards behind the screen. We use solid wedge to show the bond pointing to the front of the screen, and then we use dash wedge to show the bond pointing behind the screen. Now that we have all the bonds drawn out, we'll place the fluorines. A pro tip to keep in mind when drawing tetrahedral is that the two solid lines should be right next to each other, and then the two wedges will be right next to each other as well. Staying at steric number 4, let's look at NF3. In this Lewis structure, you can see that it has four steric numbers due to the four groups, three single bonds, and one lone pair. Since we have a lone pair on the central atom, The shape for this molecule is no longer tetrahedral. Instead, it's trigonal pyramidal. To draw NF3 in 3D, we start with nitrogen in the center, and then we draw the four lines at 109.5 degrees from each other, just like in tetrahedral. Now we're gonna place in the three fluorines like this, and then we remove the extra bond, and then we add in the lone pair. With that, we have drawn NF3 in 3D. Molecules with trigonal pyramidal geometry will have one bond on the plane, one bond sticking out of the plane, and one bond pointing to the back of the plane. Now, still at steric number 4, we now look at H2SE. In this Lewis structure, you can see that it has 4 steric numbers due to the 4 groups, 2 single bond and 2 lone pairs. Since we have 2 lone pairs on the central atom, the shape for this molecule is no longer tetrahedral. Instead, it's bent or angular. To draw H2SE in 3D, we start with SE in the center, and then we draw the 4 bonds out at tetrahedral, and then we place the 2 hydrogens on the same plane, like this, and then we remove the 2 extra bonds and we add in the lone pairs. With that, we have drawn H2SE in 3D. Molecules with bent geometry will have 2 bonds on the same plane. To recap, we have looked at 6 molecules with different geometries. HCN has 2 steric numbers with no lone pair, therefore it has a linear geometry. BCl3 with 3 steric numbers and no lone pair has a triangular shape. SO2 with 1 lone pair has a bent or angular shape. CF4 with 4 steric numbers and no lone pair has a tetrahedral shape. NF3 with 1 lone pair has a trigonal pyramidal shape. And H2SE with 2 lone pairs has a bent shape. Notice that all the solid bonds are showing bonds on the same plane as the screen. We use solid and dashed wedges in tetrahedral and trigonal pyramidal. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.